Hello everybody, I welcome you to another road tourist video on Roads channel. We are now in Upper Bavaria on the bypass, southern bypass of Bad Tölz, and we will travel on a nice national road B472 up to the end of it at Irschenberg, at where it joins the A8 motorway. So that's the southern bypass of Bad Tölz, where B472 is also concurrent with the B13, another important national road here in the region. And I said some words about Bad Tölz in a previous video, the one when I drove from Holzkirchen to Bad Tölz, and I also put some photos from the nice town during that video. I really welcome you to watch that one also and see the very nice photos at the end. Get some nice evening photos. Thanks to Jinx for giving them to me. At Bad Tölz, the conclusion is very, very nice to see. It has a very, very nice old, historical old center. And now on this intersection, B13 goes left to Holzkirchen and the motorway A8 also. So that's the main access to Bad Tölz from Munich. But we'll go to Irschenberg now. And we will be more of or less for the whole trip at the foothills of the Alps in Voralpenland region, that's a pre-alpine region at altitudes between 650 and 800 meters high. It's a very nice road to drive, I like it, this B472, because it offers some nice wide views of the area, like you see here. And it doesn't go through too many villages. There are some bypasses on the way. And it's very nice to drive it. They thought a lot about building a motorway on this corridor. A motorway to bypass Munich on the south. That should have started, I think, from Kempten, the corridor of B12 and B472, but these plans were cancelled, and instead of a motorway, they built some improvements of the national road, like some bypasses from some villages. Like now we are on a bypass of Reichersbeuer village here, and there are also some 2+1 section on hills, so some punctual improvements, and there are plans to do some more bypasses also in the future. There are plans to do a bypass of Bad Tölz also on the east part of it, not just south part of it, in order to avoid these traffic lights. That would be nice to have. As you see, we are in a rolling hills region, and the mountain starts a few kilometers to the right. Those are the first mountain peaks. A lot of grass, green grass in the area. A lot of cows here, a lot of farms. Very nice area in Upper Bavaria, and it's also not so far from a big city, from Munich, but still has a lot of traditions, traditional costumes, traditional houses. It's very nice, I like it. Uh, traffic. Some people use it to bypass Munich on the south, but it's, I think it's bearable on most days. No very big traffic jams. Traffic is flowing. And we have the village of Wackerschen in front of us. They are thinking about building a bypass also for this village. There are plans to build it on the south, on the north. The inhabitants would like to have a tunnel instead for this small village. The road authority sure doesn't want to spend so much money here, because there is really a lot of space to build a new road around. But let's see what happens. There is a association of locals that are against this road. I hope it will be built. They will build at the end something in order to bring the transit traffic out of the small village. It's better for everyone, for locals and for transit also, because you see it's also very difficult to cross the street. There's traffic lights or so. I hope it will be built sometimes. I mean, no big. This one is no big village, but still, I think also for the quality of life of these people, it will be very good. And a nice lion statue in the village center. Can go on to Tegernsee right on a county road. It's another traffic light. And that was, I think, the only village between Bad Tölz and Miesbach. The only real village. There are some groups of houses from time to time, but no big one. That's typical in Upper Bavaria, that you have there and there some small group of houses, some farms. You are at no point here in Voralpenland, far away from some people, some houses, some farms. A very nice mix of forests, pastures, some small villages. Also very nice to do bike tours here in the region. National Road B318. Left, this road goes to Holzkirchen and the motorway, and right to Achensee and Tegernsee. We'll cross it, there's a traffic light. I hope they will build a two-level intersection sometimes. If you are driving the B472, here is usually not a problem, but on B318 you can have very often traffic jams because of this traffic light. So I hope they will find another solution, a modern one. You can see also the movie I made while I was driving from Holzkirchen to Tegernsee to see what I mean. I've got into a big traffic jam. Some people are trying to avoid this jam by going on very secondary county roads through these fields or going in front of houses. That was also not so nice for these people here. We have this artificial traffic that otherwise would go on the national road, or would stay on the national road. And now we have to go down to Mangfall River Valley. Mangfall is quite a big river. It starts from Tegernsee Lake and goes down to Rosenheim and to Inn Valley. It flows into Inn. It meets at Rosenheim. It was a part of the hill, and there will be another one. So we go down in two stages. It's the Mangfall River Valley. We are in Landkreis Miesbach here, the administrative division of Miesbach. The Kreis is an administrative division. So you have in Germany the states, there are 16 states, and these are divided into Kreises. And there are about, I think, over 400 of them. Descent to Mangfall River. Miesbach was voted one of the best in Germany in terms of life quality. I think it took place 7 from over 400 crises. It's very nice to live here in the region. You have everything, you are not so far from big city, you have the mountains nearby. The region is also, it has the highest density of bio farms in Germany. So a lot of bio products here. So now we are going over Mangfall River. And from here I'm going uphill, this little hill between Mangfall and Miesbach. Let's change our gear. Quite steep. Manual one. My main car is an automatic that it's a second car of mine. And I like from time to time, I like a little bit of vintage feeling of driving a manual car. That's nice. And I'm using this car for shorter drives. Miesbach is the seat of Miesbach Kreis, but it's not the biggest town in this Kreis. Holzkirchen is the biggest one. Miesbach has about 11 or 12,000 inhabitants, while Holzkirchen has about 16, 17,000. But historically, I think Miesbach was more important. As Holzkirchen developed in the last 30, 40 years a lot after they built the suburban train line from Munich to Holzkirchen. So many people moved there as it is more accessible from Munich than Miesbach. From Miesbach you have a good train connection to Munich, but still you need much more time. And it's every 30 minutes during rush hour and every hour during the rest of the day. And now we are on a bridge over the railway from Holzkirchen to Schliersee by Richtzell. And we'll soon reach the intersection with B307 that starts here and goes to Bayrischzell. I film it. Can watch the video via to Bayrischzell. Recommend you, very nice video. We went over B307 in the mountains, to the mountains from here, from the motorway actually. And I also filmed this short concurrent section ahead. Some traffic lights as we go through Miesbach. They haven't built a proper bypass of the town. We don't go through the historical town center, but still through the edges of Miesbach. So Miesbach is a very nice town to visit. I think it was first mentioned in 11th or 12th century. It's very old. It has a. It was destroyed a few times, unfortunately, by fires, mostly. But there are still some nice houses left in the town center. Unfortunately, I don't have any photos from the center. I was here a few times, but never did some photos. Another traffic light. So I had to stop the recording for a few hundred meters. Here's the traffic. It's a radar camera, a speed camera. So pay attention while driving through Miesbach. So I lost just 200 or 300 meters of footage because the camera was getting too hot. It's quite warm and the sun was coming directly to the camera. So this roundabout we go right. By going left you will reach the motorway A8 at Vajern, and we have 8 kilometers to Irschenberg. So the state road, like I said, it's also filmed in the video from Vajern to Bayrischzell. I drove from the motorway A8 on the state road and through Miesbach and farther on B307. And now we are going to Irschenberg. not sure about it, but should be in this area. And now going down to Leitzach River Valley. Hirschenberg is the highest point on A8 motorway between Munich and Salzburg. I think it's about 740 meters high. It's quite a long descent. Leitzach is a tributary of Mangfall. They would meet at Feldkirchen and go then to the Inn Valley. So we are now down here. Village in between Miesbach and Hirschenberg. Also some group of houses. Like usual here in Upper Bavaria. And here is a bridge over Leitzach River. And we climb the hill on the other side of the valley. Speed limit is 100. The general speed limit for 1+1 highways in Germany. And I can already see the motorway where these trucks are ahead. And the motorway A8. Very close. We'll reach it soon. There is a big rest area here in Hirschenberg. Very known one on A8. That's a gas station. Shops, a McDonald's, a Bayern München Fun Shop. It's here on the right. And we have now reached the motorway, so we'll go right to Salzburg, but we'll go to Munich. And I'll finish the video as we are going on the motorway, as we are joining the motorway. And if you found this video interesting, I'll be very glad to receive a feedback from you, form of a like, of a comment. And I'll be very, very glad if you subscribe to the channel. Then you won't miss any videos like this of this beautiful region and other very nice regions in the world. So now checking the motorway. A8, and I'm saying goodbye to you, and till the next time. Bye.